News at 10.
Now at 10, a Crime Tracker 15 alert. Residents search for answers tonight as vandals terrorize their neighborhood. Vandals are wreaking havoc in Monroe. They've been smashing windows for nearly a year, and police still have no leads. But as NBC 15's Chris Pabst reports, victims are ready to fight back.
When Verla and Elwin Rocco sold their farm and retired to a quiet neighborhood in Monroe, they never thought they'd have to deal with this.
When weekend comes, you're a nervous wreck because you don't know, because it usually happens on the weekends.
Elwin and Verla Rocco have lived in fear for the past year.
You don't get no rest. You just think, well, now, are they coming tonight? Are they coming tonight?
Since November of 2009, vandals have been targeting this quiet neighborhood on Monroe's Far East Side. Three houses have had rocks or concrete thrown through windows. The Roccos have had five windows broken, including this picture window four times. All in all, it's cost about $3,000.
The second time the Rocco's picture window was broken, the vandals came here into their backyard and grabbed this retaining wall brick. They then went to the front of their house and threw it through the glass.
My granddaughter, she might not even be here with that big brick that they threw through. It could have hit her on the head or on the stomach.
Recently, the retired farmers did install motion lights and a camera, but there's only so much they can do. And so far, police have no leads.
It's very frustrating for us. It's almost like a game. They've not only been on different days of the week, but they're different hours too. So it's very hard for us to set up to watch for something like this when it's that random.
All I told is the officer, if I get a hold of the guy that comes out here and does that, they have to visit him in the hospital.
Just hope they catch him. And hoping I'm not the one that catches them, because they'd be sorry. They can't be just slapped on the hands. They got to be punished somehow.
Depending on the amount of money in damage, those responsible could face felony charges. And if you have any information, a cash reward is available. Just call the Greene County Sheriff's Department or Monroe Police. For NBC 15 News, I'm Chris Pabst.
Thank you, Chris.